Okay, so let's start here. This is sugar maple. So this is Acer saccharum. And you can recognize it because typically it kind of has 1, 2, 3 points there, and then it will kind of have these 2 points at the base. Notice that there's no teeth. At least the only teeth that there are these kind of little points right here. There's no teeth kind of along the way. So the margin is pretty much entire. This is the national flag of Canada. So if you recognize that, that is what's on the flag. Now there's some other confusing logos out there, but that's what this one looks like. Now there is variation. There's a very closely related species called Acer nigrum or black maple. And it basically has leaves that are a little bit like this. This is probably not a true black maple, but they intergrade into each other. So notice this one doesn't really have those extra points there. It's got 3 main points, and those kind of 2 bottom points are a little bit dulled. A true black maple will really kind of be missing those, and this whole thing will tend to be curled a little bit like a claw. So this is another one that's a little more like this versus a kind of a more normal sugar maple will look like this, and it'll have, you know, often with each lobe it'll be 3, sometimes even up to 5 points on each one, but they won't really be serrated in the same way as some of these other species. Now the species you're most likely to get this confused with is this one, and this is Acer platanoides. Now it's a little bit white looking, but that's because this comes from a tree that was growing on a gravel road. But if you look at the two next to each other, you can kind of tell this one has more points. It's wider, it's got extra points, and instead of just coming to these little bottom things, those are way down there, and it's kind of almost got an extra lobe. So you've got the 1, 2, 3 lobes, but then you've got 4, 5, and then you've got these 2 points on the bottom. The scientific name is Acer platanoides. Platanus is sycamore or plane tree, and they have a leaf that looks a lot like this. So it kind of looks more like a plane tree leaf. So if you see this, and we're just doing leaves right now, there are lots of other characteristics I will cover in just a bit. So over here, this is another one, same kind of thing. Now the when they're fresh, I actually have a little bit of milky sap, so you can see that white stuff coming out. And sugar maples don't have that. So it's one of the ways that you can tell the difference between those two. And those are the ones that are probably the most easily confused, because they do look similar. But we'll look at the keys in a minute. And I'll show you what those look like. So here are these two species. So on the right, I have, this is basically a kind of black maple-esque sugar maple, but they're keys or schizocarps, or sometimes they're called samaras. Technically they're schizocarps because they have 2 ovaries that are stuck to each other. Sometimes called whirligigs or wings. But these look pretty similar to black maple and sugar maple. But over here, you can see these have a much flatter actual ovary to them. The wing is larger, it's over to the side rather than kind of going straight down. This is the platanoides. This is Norway maple. So if you have the maple keys available, it's pretty hard to kind of mix those two up if you look for those. And at this time of year, we're kind of in late summer, early fall. It's fairly easy to tell them apart. Okay, now the next group I can look at, this is the red maple, Acer rubrum, and silver maple over here. Now, I've never gotten these mixed up, but a lot of students get them mixed up. So the silver maple, typically it gets its name from the back of the leaf. Now that's not to say that the red maple doesn't have a little bit of a kind of whitish back, but notice the silver maple is much whiter. It's really, really bright. So it's very obvious, especially when the leaves are blowing in the wind. The tree typically is larger. These ones, they typically, both species shed their keys a lot earlier in the season. So you're not able to see those. These have really large ones. I mean, the keys are about 2 or 3 inches long. and the tree itself is quite a bit larger. These are naturally found in wetlands, so you'd usually find these next to a river, but they get really commonly planted because they grow really fast. Red maple has an absolutely huge range. It's all over the Midwest. We don't see it that much growing wild here, but it is very, very commonly planted. So you'll see both species, and it's pretty obvious between these two. You can see we've got 3 points only. Pretty much, red maple will pretty much only have 3 points. But notice, if you're going to tell the difference between this versus a sugar maple, this has actually got some serrations on the edge of the leaf. So it's got some really pointed serrations. So if we look at the sugar maple over here, you can see that the edges here are entire. There's really not any sharp serrations on them. Whereas this guy's got little serrations, and that's true pretty much of both species, but especially of red maple. And that's one way to tell those apart. So same thing with the silver maple. You can see that the edges, it's definitely got these little points. It's kind of like a little bit of a sawtooth. And neither the Norway maple nor sugar maple, or black maple for that matter, they don't have those. Their edges are pretty much entire. So like I said, I can't show you the keys on these because they're not out at this time of year, but you can tell the difference between those two. Now what's really confusing is these two species, red maple and silver maple, they will actually hybridize to form this. And this is something. The way you can kind of tell the difference is the silver maple will usually have a much wider leaf. It's more spread out. Even when it's only got 3 points like this, it will be wide, versus the red maple, those points are pretty much together. And then the hybrid, which fortunately I don't ask my students to tell the difference between that and the hybrid, but the hybrid is actually halfway between red maple and silver maple. So this is this hybrid over here. This is, I'm pretty sure, a pure silver maple. But this hybrid is Acer X freemanii, and this gets planted quite a bit because the silver maple, it's really fast growing. Its wood is very brittle, and so it tends to break and fall on people's cars and houses, and people don't like that for kind of obvious reasons. Whereas red maple is got a stronger wood. It's a smaller tree. It's kind of less of a problem. So people said, well, maybe we can get kind of the best of both worlds. And that's when they had this hybrid. This is this Acer X freemanii, which is a hybrid of silver maple, which is Acer saccharinum, and red maple, Acer rubrum. So this is Acer X freemanii. So it's a hybrid of the two species. And it's got pretty much white, kind of like the silver maple. It's a lot more like the silver maple than it is the red maple. But you can kind of see it's got a little bit of this 3-point thing going on that the red maple has. So it's kind of between those two. So you run into those quite a bit if you're kind of in a cultivated situation, but not very common in the wild. This is Acer saccharum, sugar maple. You can see some of the variation that goes towards black maple up there, Acer nigrum. Then we've got Acer platanoides. This is Norway maple, not native, but fairly commonly escaped from cultivation. And then over here, these little guys, these are red maple, Acer rubrum, very common species. And over here, we've got Acer saccharinum, silver maple. So silver maple looks like that. So the backs of the leaves. So that's silver maple. Show you red maple, not so silver. So those are the four main species that we find in the Midwest.